What's up, y'all? It's your girl, Brittany the Brand, here with Sheen Magazine, Sheen on the Scene. And I am here with none other than the man of the hour, Dame. How you doing today, Zaw?
What up? How you doing?
I'm good. Look, we are all here for you. It's all about you today. So tell me what it's like being in the South with that West Coast swag.
It feels good. You know, I bounced out here a little minute ago. Okay. I went to college out here. So, You know, the South being receptive to the West Coast. I feel like we always been cousins, so.
Look, I know you were at Clark, correct? So what was it like with the HBCU experience, being in the South for that, and what did you take from the experience overall?
Now, it was a good experience. You know, it was, not only did it get to teach us about our own culture, but it was fun. You know, it wasn't just books. And, you know, being from Clark, you know, we got a different type of pride, you know, so CAU. Panther pride, find a way and make a way, you know. I got my degree. I know all our mottos, but shout out to the A, man. Atlanta was good. I paid them a lot of money for my tuition. I paid it off, though, so Shout out to Clark, man.
Yeah. So as far as just your whole upbringing when it comes to music and how you got started in the industry, what was the first spark for you?
I had an uncle who's like a local DJ at home, and you know, he used to let us carry his crates and stuff and carry his music. So just sitting in the corner watching him and seeing, you know, the emotions that music brought out of people. You know, he could play a song and people want to party. People want to slow dance. People could get in their feelings and crying. Like, so I seen how much control he had. And I was like, I kind of want to do that.
So it was more about the ambiance that he was setting.
Yeah, it's a vibe. You know what I'm saying? I'm big on vibes. So to watch him set the mood, like, oh, it's all R&B or I'm gonna play all the rap. Like, it just was one of the things that stuck out to me as a little kid, and you know, I utilize that today.
What's Dame's mood? What do you want people to feel when they listen to your music?
Motivation. You know, even though my music is gonna be like tempo, and you know, we might be talking a little shit on there, it's like, it's still for you to take and find some motivation out of it. So, you know, that's why I say get up out your feelings, hop up in your bag.
Yeah, and that is a great segue into feelings. Of course, you know, you have a lot of people who have been anticipating your own projects. What was the final decision for you to release your own music? Where did it start?
I just had a hard drive full of music. Ooh. And family, my friends, even, you know, Gotti was like, you're just sitting on $1 million right here. You might as well go, like, put it out and see how it do. So, you know, I we could give Gotti a little credit to say he helped push me to do this.
Yeah. So with your relationship with Gotti and how you guys actually end up connecting on a business level, what was it like realizing that you guys were so in sync when it came to that side of things?
Yeah, I mean, I don't know, maybe because like Memphis and Oakland is kind of like similar, just with a different type of vocabulary, or we both grinded for what we wanted. So I think we kind of bonded over the grind. I think he seen my early grind, and I always respected his grind. And even talking to him more and hearing more stories, it was like, damn, it's kind of similar. So I think he might have just took a liking into like my hustle. And you know, we built our bond off that.
I talked to Ant about your grind and about how you are like, I can't help people that won't help themselves, yeah. Right? You need people to already have that same energy when they come to you, because you can't build them from -1, right? What are you looking for, you know, coming from the A&R side of things, in someone that really makes you see them as a star out the gate?
I believe in originality. You know, my biggest pet peeve is saying that you the next Fo2 Doug or you the next money bag. Like, I need you to be the next you. So originality is always going to be big. And like I said, you know, you got to believe in your dreams more than you want me to believe in. Like, I shouldn't be in the studio more than you. You know, I shouldn't be passing out flyers or on social media representing you more than you is for yourself. So, you know, you got to believe in yourself more than anybody.
A&R or artist?
Wherever the check comes first.
True. Okay, so what was your biggest benefit from being an A&R, and what was the biggest pet peeve?
My biggest benefit was just learning the business. You know, I know how to do everything behind the scenes when it comes to making a record and putting a record out and making money off your records. I know how to do all of that. And my biggest pet peeve was probably just not getting the credit that you feel like, you know, I felt I deserved. But you know, it eventually came, and we're here today.
We are here today. What is one thing that you want people who are trying to get where you are, that you've seen come to you when you were in A&R or even now as an artist, that you just wish that they would adapt and be more conscious of when they step into those rooms, or they have that 60-second elevator speech with Jay-Z and they're not prepared, or they are, but they don't know how to start?
I always say stay prepared. You know, that's how my career even got cracking, was like, I worked to when my name was called. You know, I didn't try to wait until my name was called, then try to put the work in. So I say, you know, by the time they call your name, make sure you already got it ready to go.
What is one thing that you wish you knew when you started in the industry?
Man, I actually wish I didn't know nothing, because it helped shape who I am today.
Yeah.
You know, like I needed to take those L's to understand my W's today. That's a caption. Make sure
hold on, because it's a lot of people in here right now. I know they quiet, but I know y'all heard that. That was a nice gem. Say that one more time for me, please.
I don't even remember what I said. Look. That's what I said.
Like I needed to take those L's to understand my W's today.
You got to
I said it a different L's way than that.
It and appreciate the W's. All right, when you watch this back, rewind that part.
Text me that.
OJ, send us the screenshot.
That's a caption right there, but yeah.
Thank you so much for taking time out to speak with us. Sheen Magazine is always looking for what's next in the culture. Why are we still rolling? I need you to give us a drop right there, please.
All right, what up? Where I'm looking at? Right here. All right, what up? This is the boy Dane representing them three letters CMG, and you're tuned in to Sheen Magazine.
Make sure you can get us at Walmart, Walgreens, Books a Million, Barnes & Noble, and SheenMagazine.com. Don't play with us, because I am Atlanta.
Oh.
You saw how I ran up back around? Look, you saw full circle. Look, thank you very much. All right, we'll be right back.